Heidi, imagine going from teenage runaway to a $500 million property portfolio and also counting Leonardo DiCaprio and Mark Anthony among your clients, but then giving it all up. That is exactly what our next guest did, and he joins us right now live from LA. Please welcome Million Dollar Listing New York's Luis de Ortiz. Hey! Hey, buddy. Now, Luis, before we do anything, can you do me a favour and please say hello to Jessica Rowe?
Yeah.
Jessica Rowe, I love you.
Oh! Luis, you are like number one in our household. Could you also just indulge me and say hello to my husband, Petey, and Allegra, because we tape your show and watch it every Sunday morning all together. So could you say hi, Petey, hi, Allegra?
Petey, it is a pleasure to meet you. Allegra, it is amazing to meet you. I hope I see you when I come to Australia, both of you.
There you go.
All right. To our house.
And while we've got you, Luis, I'm just going to email you a list of other people I'd like you to say hello to.
I know I'm shouting, and Denise has said to me before, I don't need to shout because I have a microphone on and you can hear me. But it is so exciting to meet you because in your million-dollar listing, you are such a fireball. You are so passionate about what you do, and I love it. You're just wonderful.
Right, let's get to
And that's all the time we have for today.
I appreciate that very much.
Hey, let me just ask you a question. Just quickly, let's get back to business here. Humble beginnings for you, but then you were drawn to Manhattan and real estate. How did that all work for you?
Well, originally I went to New York. I wanted to be a film director. I wanted to tell stories. And I did a film in 2006 that was quite popular. I went to a bunch of festivals. And then I did another one in 2007, which I put a lot more work into it, but unfortunately it was a disaster. At least in my eyes, I was the only person that saw it. And then I was living in a French couch in the Upper West Side in New York City, and eventually I ended up getting my own place, met a real estate agent who told me I could be good at that. I knew nothing about it. I gave it a shot, and just like anything you put a lot of love and passion towards, if you're consistent and persistent in it, you will succeed. So that's how it happened.
And the thing is that that passion for real estate and for getting people to buy homes is extraordinary. Where do you get that passion from?
My mother. My mother, my culture, and I think it was more than just passion for real estate. It was passion for something. I think that that having a genuine passion for anything would allow you to achieve things that you never thought you could possibly get to, because you just want something so bad that you are not clouded by things when things don't go the way you expected them to. You understand that it's all part of the process. And you just are motivated on a daily basis.
Now, you actually sold over $500 million worth of real estate. Is it as glamorous as it looks on the show?
Well, on the show, we only have 1 hour per episode. And, you know, no deal actually takes place in an hour. Sometimes the reason we shoot this show for 9 months instead of 6 weeks, we normally shows like this will be shot in 6 weeks, is because the deals needed to close. Mm-hmm. They wanted every deal to be legitimate, so that when people go to the public records, they could actually see that the sale was real, the commission was real, the clients were real, etc. But they packed everything in an episode basis, which is about 44 minutes without commercials, and then. But you know, it's very beautiful. But what goes behind the scenes really is extremely tough. We shoot 9 months, four times a week, and that's not to mention our real business, which it's about 90% of what's outside of the show, because it's very difficult to get people to agree to be on the show, especially the very wealthy ones. They want to be very discreet.
Yeah.
So quite a few struggles. Did money buy you happiness?
No. Definitely no. I mean, money was not the one thing I was aiming for. I think that's the reason I got it, because I was never clouded when money was unreachable. I was always trying to aim to be the best person I could be, and therefore money came with. At some point, last year, I've been doing this, I was doing real estate for about 10 years in the show, I was doing it for about five. But at some point, I was in New York, and I've reached a level where I was successful in the eyes of everyone else. And everybody would see me on the street and they would shake my hand, they would admire me because they would see me on TV and they would respect my success. And therefore, I never wanted to question whether that was making me happy or not, because clearly I was doing something right. But truthfully, what I was doing is becoming a part of a habit that I was just so used to. and never asking a very important question that now I'm making sure I ask myself every day, which is whether what I was doing was making me happy or not, regardless of the success, money that I had with. And when I asked myself that question, I realized that I was about to answer in a way that I didn't like because it was going to be scary, and the answer was no. I wasn't no longer happy. I was no longer happy in about a year before I even asked myself the question. But when I recognized that, I left.
And Louise, I think you're a lot like me. You don't need money, especially when you've got these looks. you've actually now given it all away, haven't you?
Yeah, well, I don't see it as giving it all away. I see it as moving forward with everything I have accomplish and the people that I have met and the knowledge and experience that nobody can ever take away from me, and starting something new and fresh where I'm newly excited about and I know nothing about, and I have to continue to grow again. And I want to continue to do that for the rest of my life. I start something, I build it, I move on from it. I start something, I build it, I move on from it. I start something, I build it, and I continue and continue and continue.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Yeah. You're headed our way in March. We look forward to seeing you when you make it here. Would you please thank Luis de Ortiz, ladies and gentlemen?
Thank you for having me.